Now we're going to perform an example problem using the relationships from a previous video. The rate of effusion of an unknown gas is 2.91 times faster than that of NH3. What is the molecular weight of the gas? And we know that we can compare the rates of particular gases to their molar mass. So here we're going to say the rate of our unknown divided by the rate of NH3 is going to equal the molar mass of NH3 divided by the molar mass of our unknown. And this has to be raised to the 1/2 power. And we know that given in this particular problem, this is going to equal 2.91. So the first thing I want to do here is we typically don't like to work with things raised to the 1/2 power. So we're going to square both of these terms. So that would make our molar mass of NH3 times the molar mass of the unknown equal to 2.91, that quantity squared. Okay, so if we wanted to determine the molar mass of our unknown, we can say, to rearrange this, our molar mass of our unknown is going to equal our molar mass of NH3 divided by 2.91, that quantity squared. If we look at the periodic table, we can determine what that molar mass of NH3 is, and it's going to be 17.0 grams per mole divided by 2.91, that quantity squared. So if we go through and do the calculation for this, the molar mass of our unknown gas is going to be 2.01 grams per mole, which would essentially mean that this is going to be hydrogen gas. And we can see this, that our unknown gas is 2.91 times faster than NH3. So when we do our calculation, we would expect that the value that we determine, since our unknown is a lot faster, that means the molar mass has to be much smaller than it is for NH3. And that is indeed the case here, as we calculated 2.01, which would give us hydrogen gas.